China's Foreign Minister Wang Yi is in the Philippines for a two-day official visit. His first stop, a courtesy call and meeting with his Philippine counterpart, Enrique Manalo. Willard Cheng joins us on the line for an update. Willard?
Hi, Denise. Chinese State Councilor and Foreign Minister Wang Yi stressed the need for the Philippines and China to enhance mutual trust, saying that the only prospect for the bilateral relationship is good neighborliness, given complex and unstable times. Wang made the remarks at the start of the expanded bilateral meeting with officials led by newly designated Foreign Affairs Secretary Enrique Manalo. Wang said that during the term of President Duterte and with the, quote, correct strategic guidance from the leadership of the two countries, bilateral relations overcame all sorts of difficulties and achieved a turnaround and continuously moved forward. Wang expressed appreciation for President Ferdinand Marcos Jr.'s statements on China, describing it as the Philippines' strongest partner, and expressed readiness to work with the Philippines toward that direction and cooperate in all areas. Wang expressed confidence that this will usher in a new golden era for the bilateral relations.
With President Marcos being elected, China-Philippine relationship has turned a new page. We highly appreciate President Marcos' recent commitment to pursuing friendly policy toward China, and we speak highly of his recent statements that have sent out a very positive signal to the outside world. Such statement includes that he has been saying that China is the strongest partner of the Philippines, and he hopes to further deepen and build an even stronger relationship with China. So we are ready to work toward that same direction with the Philippines and to plan for our cooperation going forward in all areas of our comprehensive strategic partnership. And I'm confident that with our two sides working together, we can surely open up a new golden era for the bilateral relationship.
We find ourselves rebuilding after the pandemic, which has ravaged our economy, as well as our efforts to reach development goals, such as the 2030 Sustainable Development Goals. China has been a good friend and close partner of the Philippines in our recovery efforts. And we have stood shoulder to shoulder in times of great difficulty, helping one another so that we may both bring progress to our people and nations.
Still at the DFA, Manalo and Wang led the launching ceremony of the Samal Island Davao City Connector Project and witnessed the signing ceremony of the Memorandum of Understanding on Providing Financial Services to promote the cooperation between the stock exchanges of the Philippines and China. Wang is scheduled to meet with President Marcos this afternoon. Denise, back to you.
Thanks for that story, Willard. Leave Naiya alone. That call coming from former Senator Franklin Drilon, as he points out, Congress has more urgent things to do than to rename an airport. Negros Oriental Representative Arnolfo Teves Jr. filed a bill pushing to rename Manila's main gateway to Ferdinand E. Marcos International Airport. Drilon asserts the bill is divisive, ill-timed, and political. Drilon advises lawmakers to focus on reviving the economy and addressing inflation instead.